Hey guys, there is a good news for those who wanted to go to Thailand for tourism in the Phuket sandbox without quarantine. Also, we'll talk about a bad news. I hope you guys hear that Thailand sealed off rest of the Thailand from the Phuket city. So this is your host Nixon Rivera and let's start our today's video. So guys, I hope all of you are already familiar with the Phuket sandbox program, in which fully vaccinated tourists can go to Phuket without any quarantine by using the Phuket sandbox program. Also, I hope you guys know the old rule that you have to stay in Phuket for 14 days in a SHA plus hotel before going anywhere else in Thailand, but there are some changes in that rule and now you can go to specific places in Thailand only after staying 7 days in Phuket. Don't get confused, I will clear all your doubts in this video. If you want to see the video of the cheapest SHA plus hotels in Phuket, then click on the card, otherwise check out the description for that. So the TAT of Thailand, means Tourism Authority of Thailand, reported on Thursday that the Phuket sandbox recorded 9,358 foreign visitors between July 1 to 21, while rooms reservation between July and September tallied 244,703 room nights, generating 534 million baht, which is too much money. Thailand's earned a lot from tourism. Yeah, so let's come to the point. Starting 1st of August, Thailand has opened more tourist destinations for fully vaccinated tourists without quarantine. But first, you will have to go to Phuket and stay there 7 days. Yes guys, only 7 days instead of 14 days. First of all, I wanna clear, I am also confused about it, that you need to stay in Phuket for 7 days or you need to stay in a LQ hotel for 7 days. But let's consider that you will need to stay in SHA plus hotel for now. So now you will only need to stay there for 7 days in SHA plus hotel, then you will be allowed to go to other 9 specific islands, which are Koh Samui, Koh Phangna and Koh Tao in Surat Thani, and Koh Phi Phi, Koh Nagai and Rele Bay in Krabi. I love Krabi. And Koh Lak, Koh Yao Yai and Koh Yao Noi in Phangna. So these 9 islands are welcoming fully vaccinated tourists without any quarantine. But guys, you will need to land at Phuket airport and stay there for 7 nights in Phuket. After that, you can go and roam in these 9 specific islands freely. And talking about the requirements, there is nothing new rules about it. You just need to secure all the documents which you were needed before, like COE, hotel reservations, swab test bookings, health insurance, COVID-19 test, proof of vaccinations, etc. Now, I know some of you are thinking that if the staying period in SHA plus hotel has changed from 14 to 7 days, then can we go Bangkok, Pattaya or any other places in Thailand after staying 7 days in Phuket? So the answer is no guys. If you want to go to Phuket or Pattaya, then first you will need to spend your 14 days in Phuket, then only you can move to Bangkok or Pattaya. If you want to go to the 9 specific island which I have mentioned previously, then you can go to that 9 islands even after staying 7 days in Phuket. I hope it's clear now. For going to the islands, 7 days in SHA plus hotel, and to go to Bangkok and Pattaya, 14 days in SHA plus hotel. If you want to go to Pattaya or Bangkok, then you can do like this. First, go to Phuket and book a hotel for 7 days. After that, go to Krabi and stay there 7 days, and then your 14 days will be completed. Then you can move to Bangkok and Pattaya. Also, there is a bad news that Thailand has sealed off the borders of Phuket from the rest of the country, but it is only for them who want to come Phuket from the other cities. And if you want to go to the other places from Phuket, then you can easily go. But people staying in other places in Thailand can not enter in Phuket for now until further notice. So let's talk about why Thailand did this. Actually guys, Thailand did this because they really care about the health of foreign tourists, as we are their guest. Here you can read, but now as of August 3, travelers from other Thai provinces will no longer be allowed to enter Phuket. The Bangkok Post reported, overseas travelers however will be remain largely unaffected by Reuters. Per Reuters, Bangkok Post and Reuters are news sites, okay? Domestic travelers can no longer come to Phuket, but since the domestic flights from the red zones have been cancelled for a week or so, and even before that only fully vaccinated locals were allowed in Phuket, there has not been any noticeable change, Ford said. Now let's talk about why they sealed off Phuket. It was for the safety of Thai peoples or for the safety of international tourists. Read here guys, sandboxers are fully vaccinated mostly with mRNA vaccines and are tested 4 times. The worry should not be about the international travelers passing COVID-19 to the locals. The worry should be about the locals passing COVID-19 to the international travelers. See, Thailand cares about the international tourist. They are not afraid if the foreign tourist will pass viruses to locals. They are afraid if locals will pass the virus to foreign tourists. Of course, tourists are fully vaccinated and tourists are being tested 4 times. So there are no chances that tourists can pass the virus to locals. But in Thailand, most of the peoples are not vaccinated who are residing in the other places of Thailand except Phuket, and they can pass the virus to the tourist. That's what the Thailand said. These were the updates for today, guys. I hope you like this video. If you have any kind of questions, ask me in the comment section. Thanks for watching and have a good day.